I do count them. I do consider them champions. So Stanonis is a great fighter. I remember when he turned pro here in LA. I think Misael Rodriguez and Lindor were turned pro that same day. And I know
that was a packed house.
And I know what's his name, Shelly Finkel. Has him on, that's his manager. And Richard Schaefer's still involved. So I told these guys, man, that kid's a future world champion. So when he won the title, we were actually there in Texas. And they came up to me and said, remember you told me that he was going to be a champion? He's already up. But we do something else, bro. Virtue is something else. Virtue is just one of those kids that's not only very good in boxing, but he's also mentally and physically unstoppable, man. Unbeatable. And those guys are fucking hard to beat. No matter, you could be the most skilled fighter in the world, but if you got somebody, a train coming at you from round 1 to round 12, it's going to be hard to hold him back. So that's Virgil. So I give the edge to Virgil, but it's going to be a very interesting fight. But look, in that case, this is Virgil's title opportunity. This is Virgil's title opportunity. So he might be able to accept, you know, he should accept it, you know, because this is his title opportunity. After this, he knows he's going to fucking explode and be fighting for millions of dollars. You know, even though I know, and he's like, you know, he's not, you know, the first split, I know that there has to be more money there for him, you know, from Golden, because they have a contract too. So there's a minimum when he fights Rosado. So I'm pretty sure he's gonna get more money. But even if it was just that he ends up with like 500, even that is just, you know, to get that title. That's
and then he can make it same payday. Because he's very popular.
And he's gonna make three times, four times more. You know, it's like Devin Haney, who took a little bit less.
For Gambosis, yep. What, 70-30, I think it was.
Because he knew that Gambosis fight was going to be pretty easy for him, so he went and did it. Took a lot less money. You know, so that's the way it is with Virgil and Stanionis. It's not going to be an easy fight either. I can't say it's going to be easy for him.
Virgil's going to make it easy. Virgil's going to beat the shit out of him.
Yeah, Virgil's just too fucking strong, man. He's
just too strong.
His jab's too good.
Yeah.
Stanionis gets hit too much. And he's mentally also really underrated defense. You know, just because he's not flashy with the
way
he blocks very well.
He blocks very well. See, that's what
that guy's not beating.
That's what you know. It doesn't matter. Like I said, it doesn't matter who you have in front of you. If you got somebody like Virgil, it's gonna be hard, man. It's gonna be hard to get beat. You know, those guys that are already proven, like Errol Spence and Crawford. Yeah, you probably said they get the edge on Virgil, which is understandable. But when you have a kid like Virgil in front of you, not giving up and keep coming, even more stronger and stronger as the rounds go by, it's not gonna be easy. You know, Boots Ennis, great talented kid, and I'll bet you, 4-1. Boots Ennis beats Virgil. But until you're in the ring with Virgil.
different.
It's different.
But how come,
man,
I've been covering you for many, many years. I've never seen any one of your guys ever get a crazy, not Mikey. They never got a 70-30, 25-75.
Well, that's just the way the
it's now in fashion.
That's the way the organizations, the rules, and you have to go by it too. But then there's also the situation like Jose right now. Look, a few months ago, there was already talk about, you know, Jose giving up that opportunity to fight for the world title, and, you know, Regis stepped in, which, because he got married, you know. So Jose is supposed to be the number one, but, you know, and Jose, right after Regis beat up Jose right away, that's the fight we want. Rick had already been working on something else, you know, in case, whatever, you know, you never know. So he already had a date and everything. Jose, and I talked to Jose, and Jose told me, look, Robert, no. There's nothing else. I'm not going to take anything else. I'm going to fight Rick, because that's the fight that I want. You know, the WBC allowed me to step aside so I could have my wedding, and they put me ranked number one in the world. How am I going to say now I don't want to fight Regis when they did that for me? I have to fight him, and that's the fight I want. So he was all into it. So we had already... We were already, you know, planning out that fight. We were already planning out who we were going to spar. That's the fight that was going to happen. But when the money, you know, when they're talking about the first pick, it just doesn't make sense, man. For a fighter that has sold out, you know, arenas and
12 sellouts, by the way, 12.
Exactly. You know, when you know, and for him to get that, you know, it's just not fair, not fair. You know, if Jose, I haven't been reading much, but if Jose's getting a hard time, you know, it is gonna get to his head. But now we gotta work talking to, you know, forgetting what people say. Look, it depends on who the fighter is. Gallo Estrada did the same thing when the first fight happened. And we were getting ready to fight Gallo Estrada in September. And that's what they told us. The fight's going to happen in September.
Yeah.
So Josh was getting ready. And then, a few weeks before, right? Like a few weeks before, a month before, Gallo decides to vacate the title.
Yep. I remember.
You know, because, yes, his cut was really small. But I'm pretty sure, you know, there would have been a little more, you know, even us, we would have been a little more flexible at that time.
It was to make it happen.
Just to make it happen. At that time, Golden Boy was still involved with Franco. So we would have, you know, maybe not get the money that he's getting, you know, against Chocolatito or those type of guys, but a little bit better than what the first bid was. But he still decided not.
Okay, let me ask you this.
You know what I mean? So why, why do people give him such a hard time to Jose? If they are, when somebody like Gallo, why? Because Gallo just had a fucking great ass win right now. So people forget about that he didn't want to, you know what I mean? Oh, well, he did the right thing because he moved on not to fight Josh, to fight Chocolatito and become champion again. Yes.
But Robert, the way I look at it, listen, I'm not a mathematical genius, but if Regis fights Jose and it's a 50-50 fight and the fight generates $3 million, that's $1.5 million. If he does the 65-25 split or whatever, 35, and the total is 800,000, he only makes 550. Do you know what I mean?
Like, so
why not make 1.5?
Even Regis.
Great fighter, won the title.
Great person, you know, his team. I like his team very well, you know, the manager and everything. Great people. But even Regis himself, his manager, you know, could have a good talk with him and say, look, it's actually the fight that we want too. You know, it's a great fight, big fight. Let's split it. You know, Regis could say the same thing. Could say, you know what? If I understand your position, well, let's fucking split it.
Let's all make money.
Let's all make money. You know, but you know, I think we already have.
Could they still do it, or it's over?
Maybe after the next fight. Why not? It's still there. The fight's still gonna be there, and I think the fight will happen actually. But it'll probably be. Where they don't have to go to first bid, maybe they put something out. But Jose is gonna fight March 25th, and you know, it's already done, it's already set. We're gonna have a good card. We're gonna have, I think, one of my, I think Raymond's gonna be in that card.